Hi, this is Julie Harland, and I'm your math gal. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where you could search for any of my videos organized by topic. All right, we're going to solve this value mixture problem, and we're going to use two variables. I also have made a video showing how to solve it using one variable. A store sells Colombian coffee for $4 per pound and French coffee for $7 per pound. They decide to make a 120-pound blend and sell it for $5 a pound. How many pounds of each type of coffee should be used? Right, so what do we have here? We've got some Colombian coffee, and we have some French coffee. And we're going to put that together in a big mix. Right? Now, how much is the Colombian coffee per pound? So if I look right here, it says the Colombian coffee is $4 a pound. So if I'm going to put I always like writing the price per pound underneath. So the Colombian coffee is $4 a pound. Now, what about the French coffee? The French coffee, it says, sells for $7 a pound. All right, so $7 a pound for the French coffee. And what about the mixture? Let's see. I'm going to sell the mixture for $5 a pound here. So my mixture is going to be cost $5 per pound. Now, what do we know? How much is there in the mix? Well, right here, we're going to make a 120-pound blend. So I know the total amount of pounds of coffee, total pounds of coffee is 120 pounds. Okay, now, if you know how to use two variables, you could say, well, I'm looking for two different things, not one thing, so let's just give each of them a variable. And you could use any variables you want. I'm going to use C and F. If you prefer, you could use X and Y. Now, I like to use letters that make sense for what I'm looking for. So, since Colombian starts with a C, I decided to use C, and French started with an F, I decided to use F. And the reason is when I'm done and if I write F equals, I know that must have been how many pounds of French coffee I needed. All right, now, how much would the total cost of each type of coffee be? Well, let's see, how much would the total cost of the Colombian be? Well, I've got C pounds, $4 per pound. We multiply that together. So that would cost 4C, right? Like for instance, if you had 2 pounds, it would cost $8, right? 4 times 2. How much would the French coffee cost? That would be $7 for each pound of French, and there's F pounds of French coffee, so that would be 7F. So if they were going to mix these two blends together, they would pay 4C for the Colombian, 7F for the French, so that would be their total cost of making the blend. But they want that to be the same as if they just had the total 120 pounds at $5 per pound. So the cost for $5 at $5 a pound for 120 pounds is 5 times 120. And that gives me one equation. Now, to solve a system of equation with two variables, you need to have two equations. And what's the other equation? Well, I've got C plus F equals 120. So don't look at the price. If we just want to talk about how many pounds of coffee, I've got C pounds of Colombian, F pounds of French, and that is 120 pounds. So that's my second equation. Just C plus F equals 120. So if you want to notice, this is just the number of pounds I'm talking about, right? And now we have two equations and two variables. Oops, went too far again. Okay, now you can solve these two equations in more than one way. You can use the addition method where you try to get one of the variables to cancel out, or what you can do is take one of the equations and solve for one of the variables and plug it into the other one. I'm going to do that for this problem. How about if I take C in this second equation and I'm going to solve for it? So I need to subtract F from both sides. So if I just subtract F from both sides, what does that give me? C equals 120 minus F. Now, there are, at least three other ways you could solve this system. This is just one method using the substitution method. I'm going to plug that into the other equation. So I have, let's see, C, right? And I have a C here. So I'm going to plug 120 minus F in for this C that I see up there. First, I'm going to rewrite this equation. 4c plus 7f, and I'm going to go ahead and just write what 5 times 120 is, and that's 600. All right, so now we're going to go ahead and plug in 120 minus f for c. So I'm going to plug in 120 minus f for c plus 7f equals 600. And by the way, you could put the video on pause and finish this on your own anytime you want. Let's do the distributive property here. 4 times 120 is 480, minus 4 times f is 4f. And then I have plus the 7f equals 600. So I've got the two terms with f, so I'm going to combine like terms here, and at the same time, I'm going to go ahead and subtract 480 from both sides. So that gives me 3f, right? Because negative 4 plus 7 is 3, equals 120, and if you divide by 3, we get 40. All right, what's f stand for? Pound, number of pounds of French coffee, right? So just keep in mind that's what it stood for. Now, so we know F. How are we going to figure out C? I'm going to go back up here. Plug that in for F, right? So what would C equal? C would be 120 minus 40. Oh, you could see that. So C would be 80. So we got F is 40, we got C is 80, and so basically it means I want to have 80 pounds of the Colombian coffee. All right, so let's write down what we've figured out so far. All right, so we got that F equals 40, we got C is 80, so this must mean use 40 pounds of French coffee and 80 pounds of Colombian coffee. But now we want to check that, right, in our original problem. So let's look back at the original problem. All right, here is our original problem. A store sells Colombian for $4 per pound. All right, now we're going to use 40 pounds of the French and 80 pounds of the Colombian. Okay, so for this Colombian coffee that costs $4 a pound, let's see, how much would that cost? For the Colombian coffee, we would end up with 80 pounds at, I'll make it simple and just write 80 at, 80 pounds. Let's see, the Colombian was $4 a pound, right? $4 a pound. So that would cost $320 for the Colombian. Now, what about the French? I'm going to use 40 pounds of French. And let's see, French costs $7 a pound, right? It was $7 a pound. So that was $280. So if they used 80 pounds of the Colombian and 40 pounds of the French, they would have spent $600, correct? So the question is that the same as if they just bought the whole blend, right? Now here it is. They decide to make a 120-pound blend and sell it for $5. How much would that be that they would get back if they sold 120 pounds at $5? Right? If they mixed it all together and they sold it, that would be the same $600. So yes, it checks. So therefore, What we have up here was correct. We just want to use 40 pounds of the French coffee and 80 pounds of the Colombian coffee. Please visit my website at yourmouthgal.com, where you can view all of my videos, which are organized by topic.